These are two extremely different electric mountain bikes. One is arguably the cheapest decent level full suspension e-bike, and the other, one of the world's most expensive.
The Decathlon Stylus, and it's £2,699. The Mondraker Crafty Carbon RR SL, that is £10,799.
How much difference in the real world does that extra cash actually get you? Will you be better, faster, and have more fun on the more expensive e-bike? Or does it make sense to buy something cheaper, and in these extreme examples, save over £8,000?
They have exactly the same motor, the same travel, pretty different in terms of the geometry and the setup.
In this video, I want to share the real-world differences between these two e-bikes. Aluminium versus carbon, wireless versus cable, entry-level components versus factory-level bling. This is supermarket bargain basement versus e-bike exotica.
So what we've got with the Mondraker is really the pinnacle of R&D when it comes to e-bike design. The whole bike is carbon fibre, and the battery has been internally mounted into the frame to keep the weight down. The weight on this when you buy it is 19.4 kilos, so it is a super, super light electric mountain bike. In fact, one of the lightest full-powered mountain bikes in the world. The geometry has been refined over years of development, and they would have had a lot of test rides, a lot of feedback from racers, from enduro to World Cup racers, to give them feedback about how to develop the frame. And Mondraker's forward geometry concept has been around for quite some time, extending the reach and making the bike feel super stable at speed while keeping the chainstay nice and short to give a real nice playful and active feel.
Geometry is a branch of mathematics that studies the sizes, shapes, positions, angles and dimensions of things. And at this point, if you're thinking that the bike's geometry can't be that much different on a cheaper bike, there's some pretty extreme differences here, and it can totally transform the way a bike feels when you're riding it.
Geometry really is pretty wild, to be fair. The chainstay is longer than the reach, which is unusual. This is an XL, but it is really short. It, to me, feels like they've not really put any thought into the geometry in terms of a performance mountain bike aspect. It's totally rideable, but it feels way more sketchy and more dangerous compared to something that is well thought out.
So the cheap bike has a short reach and a really long chainstay. What does that actually mean in the real world? Well, short reach means the bike feels way less stable at high speed, and I found it quite sketchy on these descents. Longer chainstay meant that it felt slower and less eager to turn in, and required more body effort to get the back end round the corners, compared to the very well thought out geometry on the Mondraker, which felt composed, safe and calm, and the suspension and the chassis provided a lot of input to the rider. It feels like you can take on pretty much any terrain in the world on this bike. But I have to say, I got totally used to the shortcomings on the Decathlon cheap e-bike and adapted my riding to match. Perfect? No. Rideable and fun? Hell yes. And actually, short reach is often preferred by some riders. It can make the bike feel a bit nippier and more agile. And a long chainstay often helps with climbing. A longer rear centre can be more stable up steeper climbs, helping to keep the front end calm. See, geometry is all really a little bit of a compromise.
The suspension on this bike is flagship suspension. It's Fox factory. You've got loads of adjustment, high speed, low speed, rebound. And each one of those controls, each one of those settings, makes a real difference to the feel of the suspension.
The entry-level suspension on the cheap e-bike felt much more harsh and less forgiving. It transferred a lot of chatter from the trails into my arms. But let's not forget that this suspension probably is no worse than that of bikes of 5 or so years ago. All right, it's not as refined as the luxury stuff, but it still works well enough to have some awesome trail blasts.
The gears are totally wireless. The dropper post is totally wireless. There's no cables, or there's minimal cables running inside the bike. It's only a speed controller cable and the rear brake cable. Wheels are carbon fiber, and the overall ride on this bike is sublime. I did a review of this bike when it first came out last year. The rear suspension and the linkage is absolutely fantastic. So what you're paying for is years of research and development into frame design and geometry to bring out the most refined example of an electric mountain bike possible, paired with the top tier components. So the absolute cutting edge in terms of the equipment and the components. We're talking wireless components, we're talking super lightweight drivetrain, super lightweight frame, and it is really the pinnacle of electric mountain bike design.
So the pinnacle of e-bike design. Yes, it's bloody great fun to ride. It's sharp, stable, composed, and all of those other good words you might use to describe an outstanding electric mountain bike. Wireless shifting works amazingly well. The lightweight, overall weight help it to feel more nimble and agile on the trail. And the bike aesthetics arguably look better and neater designed. But at the end of the day, I don't really care about all of that so much, because for exactly 25% of the price of this bike, I can have 85% of the fun. And there's a certain amount of satisfaction you get in upgrading the bike over time. This is how the Decathlon Cheap e-bike now looks. Although now, it's not exactly cheap. I spent a huge bunch of cash upgrading the tyres, components and suspension. And it's even better than it was, and still less than half the cost of the superbike. Biking to me is all about having fun. This Cheap e-bike allows you to have just as much fun as some of the big guns in the mountain bike world. And just because it's cheap, doesn't mean you won't have an absolute blast. Yes, 10K superbikes are amazingly awesome too, but don't feel you need to spend many thousands of pounds more, because it won't necessarily make you faster, better, or happier.